it's me again.
Hello, it's me again. My hair is purple. See, it's my natural color. Okay, I'm going to do a few things. I've been busy trying to plan this kind of last minute trip. So, and I've been rooting. I had to stop rooting Vito for a little bit because I ran out of hair. So I was rooting my friend's Rue. So I got him partially rooted. As soon as I finish Vito, I'll show him to you. He's really cute. He's going to have like messy curls. I got Zoe some new eyes because I like these way better. They look much better on her. Also darkened her lips a little bit. She looks better, I think. What do you guys think? Oh, I probably have a mommy already for her, but I have several Zoe kits. So, and we are painting, Missy. So she's another Blick kit. I've decided that I love curly hair, and all my babies, except for my my Asian babies, will have curly hair. Because that's all I'm buying lately. So I decided I'm going to go ahead and paint Michael, since, you know, I stripped him. And I'm finishing up Ayanna. She still, I haven't done anything to her, so she still has just a blue, yellow ochre, I think a mottling that didn't really take. I probably need to do another mottling on her, maybe. Maybe I'll just leave her without. And she's a bigger baby. Sometimes I put mottling on my toddlers, and sometimes I don't. Just depends. She's not really a toddler, she's just a bigger baby, but. Oh, you know, sizes of babies, even toddlers have mottling, so. Anyway, and she's had purple. Daxazine purple. So, I think I'm going to do a another yellow on her. Is it raw? Raw sienna, I think? No. What is it? Raw sienna, I was right. Okay, so I'm going to go put Miss Zoe back in her little spot over there hanging on the rack. And I still need to put the armature in. Madeline has been doing a lot of things, but getting very little done except rooting. So I got to put her armature in. I got to put Amelie over here. I just stuck her little pacifier on her. I gotta put her together. I'm kind of regretting doing the painting the hair in the front, but I don't know. Maybe it kind of looks cute too. You guys can see her eyes today. That's interesting. My camera's so weird. Okay, so I will be back. Okay, I thought I would include you guys in the last leg that I'm gonna do. The last leg. I'm going to do her. So this has the raw sienna on it. That's her little footy. There's still a lot of pink in her skin, which is fine. But she needs I'm going to do a teal, I think. And then we'll see where we're at on her. But I'm going to do some painting on this one. So we're going to go ahead. She has that kind of vinyl that you have to be really careful with to make sure you blend everything in. Well, if you paint like me. or it ends up streaking, so you have to be. That's why I have like a million brushes out here. Well, she's not huge, so I'm just covering the whole leg and foot. And I'm just kind of pulling off some of the excess. I'll show you guys her little birthmark, you know, because it had that, the vinyl had that little black mark in the, you know, inside the vinyl. That just happens sometimes. It's not like a flaw. It's not going to hurt the vinyl or anything. It's just, I should have noticed and sent it back. So I could have one that's, you know, pristine. But I didn't because I didn't notice it. But it's okay because I made it a little birthmark, which makes her more unique. See? Making lemons. Okay. So like I said, you have to be careful with her vinyl. Some vinyl, just the paint just kind of soaks in. With this vinyl, it pools. So I'm being careful, especially around the sides of the legs, like there and the front, because that's where you're gonna get more streaks, and around the edges. Just do all this, and then I'm going to take this little one and get around the toes and the ankle and stuff. So I need to make sure that all that is. And not puddled and streaked and all that stuff. Still have a little bit excess on here. I'm gonna put a little more. We'll mix it up. It won't be so pink. I'm gonna put that as the first layer. Okay, ding ding. Here we go. Make sure everything looks good. Okay. See, she's got plenty of yellow now in her skin. So we're good on the yellow. Okay, I'll show you guys her little. A little birthmark that I made. Well, there used to be a little. Well, there is a black mark in there, but I made a birthmark to make it look more natural. So I'm gonna probably do a teal on her, and then more powders, and we'll see how she looks. Okay, let's put this stuff away. I don't know if I need any more blush in here. It's the blush color, the white color, sinks to the bottom. So when I mix it up, I'll show you. It looks more. See, it doesn't look as pink. But I think I'm going to put a little more in there. And make sure I get it all mixed up, because it just wants to sink to the bottom. Yeah, it's just pinky. Pinky, pinky. Okay, I'm going to get some brushes. I got organizers for my desk. So, I'll show you guys how my desk looks after I get it all organized. Because it's a mess. I'm tired of all these jars. And I got something to put all these little things of paint in. My brushes. Kind of floofy. Sorry. There we go. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and put a layer of this on. Let me see how this looks on her vinyl. Okay, that looks good. And then I may do a blue over the top of this. Try to make her more pale. Oh, she's heavy. This vinyl is so thick. Go over this, make sure we got it everywhere. I don't know. Maybe a peachy wash would have been better, but We went with pink. I got that. Remember, I got that one. Oops, see the hair. I got that one stuff supposed to work on gray. Gray vinyl, because that's what this is, basically, is gray vinyl. There's a hair. I've been rooting a lot, so I'm probably, even though I have my apron on, I'm dragging hair around with me. Ouch. It's killing my fingers. Brush and not that one. This one. Get inside the ears and around the ears. Okay. Let's see. It's a little more pale, but. Just trying to kind of neutralize the gray tone a little bit. I'm gonna look over here in this other light. Yeah, that looks better. My husband's in there because he's off work this week. Okay. Off, I think it's starting to hurt me. These rings keep my joints from bending backwards. I haven't been wearing them for a while, but I need them. Especially on this thumb's getting really bad. It's like coming out of the socket all the time. When I put this finger inside the head, it rubs up against my ring. It hurts. Okay. So, what else was I going to tell you guys? I don't remember. I already told you about my desk. Just got to get these babies up for sale and get Madeline finally finished. She's been finished since Christmas, but I want her to be able to stand up better, so I think my original idea is better now that my husband figured out how to get the armatures in place. Then I think it's a better idea. Alright, so I'm going to be back and I'll show you guys how she looks right now. Okay, so I did work, like, without you guys. I'm so mean. I think I'm done with her. She looks good, huh? I did the, the turquoise wash, and I don't think I should do any more on her. I did powders. I like the way she looks. She looks like a nice little pale baby. Could do some, blonde hair on her. I like those eyes on her, too. So, yeah, I think I should just go ahead and varnish her. I went ahead and did a Titan buff wash on her too to make her more pale. I may do a light blue because I want to keep her pale too. And I did a one on Michael, too, which is kind of weird. He doesn't need one, but a friend of mine is doing them on the hands and feet, so I did one on, and then an extra one on the hands and feet, just to make the hands and feet more pale. So, I just need to do powders on the rest of Ayanna's hands, a little bit more, and darken some of the, because her vinyl's kind of strange. The powders don't want to stick to them. I have to do them over and over and over. So I might just seal them in. So I'll be back. Hopefully I can be I'll be done with Vito and I can show you him before I put this video up. But I will be showing him soon. So I'll be back soon. Okay, so look. I organized. Sort of, kind of. Okay. She's so cute. I love her skin tone, how it turned out. It's so cute. Okay, so I got this little plastic boxy thing. And it's got little sections. So I got, these are my brushes I use for my powders. These are my, like, hair painting things. These are my pencils. And these are my my painting brushes. And then my big painting brushes I have in this, my kabukis, I have in this plastic thing. And then I got this weird thing. It was like a puzzle to put it together. Also, I had some sensory issues because that rubbing together of the like fake wood stuff bothered me. So my husband had to finish it. So I got kind of a modge podge here. I got all my paint. I got my kabuki that I use to, I got the big ones over here. The ones I use for the brown. Well, they're all big. Maybe I should just put that here. There we go. So I got all my paints that I've mixed. I got some eyes back here. That's my light blue that I'm planning on using. I might just use the... I got some brushes to clean off the dolls. I got my... This is my white. The one I'm currently using. So I figured they have the holes for brushes and stuff back there. So I just put those two because those are the ones I use. I can just grab them. I have all my varnishes and stuff over here. I've been putting this around the flanges to make them slippy slidey. I had the lid off of this and I dumped it over. It's my pledge. And I dropped an eye in it. I'm like, what is that sticky stuff? And I had a little puddle right here. So that wasn't good. That's me cleaning. I got some more eyes over here, but I'm just keeping them here. And I have a box over here that has more kabuki brushes. Just in case I need them for more painting. I don't know if I'll ever use them, but I keep them in there. They're more fluffy. Okay, so this side is a mess still, and it's because I can't reach over there because I have this here. So it's still kind of a mess in here, but I'm working on it. So I'm sort of kind of organized, much better than having a bunch of jars. I still have some jars. These are my sponges I use for, these had, olives in them, that, sponges I use to rub the powders in. These are sponges I use for mottling, and I have some, throwaway sponges back there, and I have some sticks that are down here so I can grab. So, yay, that's my idea of organization. Okay, so, I got my water, so I'll be back. I'll do a little bit of painting. I want to varnish her with the first coat of varnish. And then I can do her little eyebrows. I just love her. She's so cute. Okay, so I ordered those powders from, Pup and Traumalon. And they turned out to be this Cryolin. Yeah. See, I got their eyeshadows, and I couldn't find one that I liked. This is apparently the blush. I did not know that it was this brand, or I would have bought the palette. It said that it was Pup and Traumalon powders, which is not the truth. Anyway, these are kind of pinky. That one's really pinky. And this one's kind of more purpley. And then I like this one. I've tried this one. It works really good. You can tell that these are a little bit better than the pan pastels. They seem to take better. I tried some on my practice head, and I liked it, so I put some on Missy. You see, I've done some work on her. I'll explain what I did so far. And these are going to be her eyes. So I got some more eyes. I got these in dark blue. Put those back in there. And then I got these ones. These are a little more light shade, but they're all 24. So they're for toddlers. And this is my see where I get all my containers. They're from eyes and stuff like that. So I'm going to buy a little palette for this, a little magnetic palette to stick these in, because I have nowhere to put this now. I'm not going to open these other ones. Open those after I get my palette, and I can put them in it. I don't have to worry about them. So I'll have to find a little container for that. Okay, so far, I've been working on Michael and Missy. And so far they have just the, the two pale, the two pale washes that I did with I did the pink one, and then I went ahead and did a Titan Buff wash. And I've done, I did ultramarine blue and a yellow ochre. Her head's still a little, out of. After I put the, it's sticking out too much over here. After I put the polyfill in, you won't be able to tell. She looks like she got whacked on the head. She's alright. I'll probably stuff some polyfill in her when I'm, fix it. Because I'm not going to put more hot water in her. Because I already had too many problems with that. I'm just going to use pastel colors on her from now on. See how we can lighten her up. Because I want her to be somewhat pale. So, probably do a violet wash next. But I think I'm going to end the video because it's getting too long. And I want to put out another one. My little Ayanna, she's so cute. I'm going to put some varnish on her. So, I'll be right back. Okay, other than, dyeing my hair and stuff, I haven't done much. I'm still working on Vito. He's got kind of thick hair, so he's still got his swirl I'm doing. So, next video, I'll show him to you. And I still have not put Amelie together, and I have not put the armature in Madeline, so hopefully we'll get one of those done today. We'll have them done by next video. I should put Madeline up for sale. I need to start moving. So I'll be back. If you guys like what I'm doing, please like and subscribe, and go get an authentic doll kit like Ayanna. By Gundrun. Sorry, Legler. And some paint and stuff. And paint a reborn because it's fun. Okay, bye.